Hello everyone, I am from CSE department, Lailpur Khalsa College of Engineering, presenting this video for Simulation and Modeling VTCS601. And today's topic of discussion is comparison of several system designs. As you know, in the previous lecture we have already discussed about the comparison of two system designs, under which we have discussed how we can get the independent sampling, confidence intervals, and how we can generate the common random numbers, and to get the confidence intervals with specified precision. So today, let's move on with comparison of several system designs. Here, suppose that a simulation analyst desires to compare K alternative system designs. So the comparison will be made on the basis of some specified performance measures, that is theta I of system I for let's say I equals to 1, 2 or till k, any can be the values. So many different statistical procedures have been developed that can be used to analyze simulation data and draw statistically sound interference. So these procedures can be classified as either being fixed sample size procedures or sequential sampling, or we can say multi-stage procedures. So in the first type, a predetermined sample size, we can say a run length or number of replication, is used to draw inference by hypothesis test or confidence intervals. Let's take example of fixed sample size procedures that include the interval estimation of a mean performance measure and the interval estimation of the difference between the mean performance measures of the two systems. So the advantage of fixed sample size procedure include known or easy estimated cost, let's say in terms of computer time before running the experiment. So the time before running the experiment could be the estimated cost, because it is time is a valuable resource. So when computer time is limited, or when a pilot study is being conducted, a fixed sample size procedure might be appropriate. It has been observed in some of the cases clearly inferior system designs may be ruled out at this early stage. So a major disadvantage is that a strong conclusion could be impossible. For example, the confidence interval could be too wide for practical use, since the width is an indication of the precision of the point estimator. So in this case, the hypothesis test may lead to a failure or to reject the null hypothesis. A weak conclusion in general means that there is no strong evidence one way or the other about the truth or false of the null hypothesis. So in case of a sequential sampling scheme, which is also termed as multi-stage, so it is one in which more and more data are collected until an estimator with the pre-specified precision is achieved, or until one of the several alternatives is selected, with the probability of correct selection being larger than a pre-specified value. So a two-stage, or we can say multi-stage procedure, is one in which an initial sample is used to estimate how many additional observations are needed to draw the conclusions. So with the specified precision, here taking an example of two-stage procedure for estimating the performance measure of two systems. Let's say the systems are theta I and theta j. So the proper procedure to use dependence on the simple goal of the simulation analyst. Some possible goals can be to estimate each parameter of theta I, comparison of each performance measure theta I to a control theta 1, where theta 1 could represent mean performance of an existing system. So next can be all pairwise comparisons of theta I minus theta j can be done. Here let's say for where I is not equal to j, as they are the separate or distinct independent systems, and all the selections of the best theta I could be largest or the smallest one. So here the first three goals will be achieved by the construction of confidence intervals. The number of such confidence intervals is you can say where C equals to K, where C equals to K minus 1, or C equals to K of K minus 1 divided by 2, which have been already discussed in the previous lectures. So here the fourth goal requires the use of a particular type of statistical procedure known as multiple ranking and selection procedures. Here next we are having Bonferroni approach to multiple comparisons. In this, let's suppose that C confidence intervals are computed and that the ith interval has confidence coefficient, let's say 1 minus alpha I. So here let Si be the statement that the ith confidence interval contains the parameter being estimated, or we can say the difference of two parameters that we need to estimate here. So this statement might be true or false for a given set of data, but the procedure leading to the interval is designed so that the statement Si will be true with probability 1 minus alpha I. So when it is desired to make statements about several parameters simultaneously, as in goals 1, 2 or 3 that we have already discussed in the previous slide, so the analyst would like to have a high confidence that all statements are true simultaneously. So the Bonferroni inequality statements that says that P for all statements Si are true, where I equals to 1, 2 till C, which has to be greater than equal to 1 minus summation of J, which is equals to 1 to C of alpha J, which is equals to 1 minus alpha E. Here alpha E is the overall error probability, provides an upper bound on the probability of a false conclusion. Here P of one or more statements, that is Si, is false if I equals to 1 goes till C, which is less than equal to alpha E, or we can say P of one or more of the C confidence intervals does not contain the parameter being estimated, which is less than equal to alpha E. Thus alpha E provides an upper bound on the probability of a false conclusion. So to conduct an experiment that involves making C comparisons, first select the overall error probability, that is alpha E. So the Bonferroni approach is having the advantages. A major advantage is that it holds whether the models for alternative design are run with independent sampling or with common random numbers. So by using this approach, we can easily predict whether the system is independent, whether their sampling or common random numbers are dependent or generating from other module or not. So we can conclude that. But the major disadvantage of this approach is making a large number of comparisons, which ultimately increase the width of each individual intervals. Let's say for a given set of data and a large sample size, it generates very longer time durations because of the generation of various comparisons, which ultimately is not feasible for small sample sizes because the time duration of generating the comparison is way longer than the individual samples. So here we recommend that the approach must be used when there are a small number of comparisons are being made, and let's say 20 or so comparisons appear to the practical upper limits. So corresponding to goals, that is 1, 2 and 3 that were discussed earlier, there are at least three possible ways of using the Bonferroni inequality when we are comparing K alternative system designs. First one is individual confidence intervals. Here, construct a 100 of 1 minus alpha I percent of confidence interval for parameter theta I by using the expression that is previously mentioned, which is H equals to T of alpha by 2 of interval R minus 1 S divided by under root R, which is the half length of confidence interval, in which case the number of intervals is C equals to K. If independent samplings were used, the K of confidence intervals would be mutually independent, and thus the overall confidence level would be 1 minus alpha 1 multiplied by 1 minus alpha 2 multiplied by so on till 1 minus alpha c, which is larger but not by much than the right side. So that is the c confidence intervals. So this type of procedure is most oftenly used to estimate multiple parameters of a single system rather than to compare other systems, because multiple parameters estimates from the same system are likely to be dependent. So here the Bonferroni inequality typically is needed. So next we are having when a comparison is to be to an existing system. So we have to compare our newly generated system with the already existing system. Here we have to compare all the designs to one specific design, usually to an existing system. That is, we have to construct a 100 of 1 minus alpha I percent of confidence interval for theta I minus theta 1. So here the number of comparisons will be, that is C, which is equals to K minus 1. So this type of procedure is most often used to compare several competitors to the present system in order to learn which is better. So the third possible way could be all pairwise comparisons. So in the third approach, we have to compare all designs to each other, that is for any two system designs, that is I not equal to j, construct 100 of 1 minus alpha ij percent of confidence interval for theta I minus theta j. So with k designs, the number of confidence intervals computed is c equals to, that is the number of comparisons, c equals to k of k minus 1 divided by 2. So the overall confidence coefficient would be bounded below by 1 minus alpha e, which is ultimately equals to 1 minus summation of further summation alpha ij, where I is not equal to j. So it is generally believed that the common random number will make the true overall confidence level larger than the right. So here the worst case could be the lowest possible overall confidence level. Next we are having Bonferroni approach to selecting the best. Here, suppose that there are k system designs and the unknown expected value of the ith system performance is theta I. So we are interested in which system design is best. So where best means having the maximum or minimum theta I depending on the problem. So here we have to focus on parameters theta I minus maximum where j is not equal to I of theta j and the value of I goes from 1 to till k, and if system design I is the best, it is the difference in performance between the best and the second best. So if system design I is not the best, it is the difference between the system I and the best. More precisely, here we want to basically check the probability that we select the best system to be at least 1 minus alpha. So here theta I minus theta j has to be greater than equal to the epsilon of all I systems. So here I is not equal to j. So where epsilon depends on the problem here. So if there are systems that are within epsilon of the best, then we will be satisfied to select either the best or one of the near to best design. So both the probability of correct selection, that is alpha 1 minus alpha, and the practically significant difference of epsilon will be under our control. So this procedure can be accomplished by undertaking two stages of simulation. So here we have two stages of the whole procedure. In the first stage, R naught replications are obtained from each of the system design. Those system designs that are statistically significantly inferior to the other or screened out systems, that means that they are estimated from further considerations with confidence I minus alpha divided by 2. So if more than one system survives the screening, then the survivors receive enough additional replication to select the best one. Or system design within epsilon of the best can be taken. So here, the best system will be considered with the confidence of 1 minus alpha divided by 2. So on the whole, in the first stage, what we need to do is, firstly, we need to obtain the R0 replications from each system. Then we have to screen out, that is, delete the statistically inferior systems, those whose performances are not as expected. So the inferior ones are filtered out, and in this, if only one system survives, then we will stop, otherwise we will keep on comparing them. So in stage 2, if the survivors are more than one, that means more than one system survived, so we'll keep on comparing them, do additional replications to select the best one. So we will compute them, make more and more changes to the parameters inputs, and more replications are generated and the resultants will be compared with each other so that we can get the best one. So this is how we can compare multiple system designs, or we can say several system designs. And for this we can use the Bonferroni approach for multiple comparisons, under which we can select the best system by using the Bonferroni approach. This is all for today's lecture. Thanks for hearing. Thank you.